Hello everyone, welcome to Comprehensive Current Affairs presented by Narayana IAS Academy. About me, I did my BTEC from CBIT Hyderabad and I wrote Civil Service Mains in 14, 15, 16, 17 and Forest Service Mains in 15 and 16. As we know that during partition of India and Pakistan, many of Hindu and Sikhs who were living in Pakistan have migrated to India and Muslims have migrated to Pakistan. While they were living in their original homes, they constructed many prominent religious institutions like temples, Sikhs, etc. Okay, according to 1974 Protocol on Visits to Religious Shrines in Pakistan and India, any person can get a visa to visit a list of shrines which are under this protocol. However, because of costly visa regulations, costly travel, etc., many of people don't visit these religious institutions. Therefore, Karatapur corridor has come under significance. Let us study about this Karatapur Gurudwara. This Gurudwara is located on the bank of River Ravi, 2 kilometers from the international border of India and Pakistan. This is important because Guru Nanak Dev settled in this place and gave religious sermons after his missionary travels. This is also the spot where Guru Nanak Dev has died. Therefore, this is very important religious institution for Sikhs. This is, at present what is happening is that many of the Indian government has installed telescopes. From these telescopes, the pilgrimage is paid to this institution. However, recently, the cabinet of India has decided to construct a corridor from Dera Baba Nanak. This is a village on Indian side of border to international border. And Pakistan government has reciprocated by constructing another corridor from Karatapur to international border. Basically, on this corridor from here to here, Indian Sikhs can go there visa free. There is no need for visa. This measure by Indian government will help to improve people-to-people relations. This is very important to improve peaceful ties between both the countries. Okay. Now, there are some concerns regarding this. As we already know that in mid-1980s, when Khalistan movement, which is a separatist movement was for Punjab, is under its peak, ISI institution of Pakistan has supported this. Therefore, there are misgivings in the security establishment that Karatapur corridor may be another attempt by Pakistan to woo the Sikh community, which is aimed at creating unrest in Punjab. Okay. However, if you going forward, this is very important in establishing good relations between the both countries. And this can take forward peace and stability and improve people-to-people relations. Okay. Rupee appreciates. Last month, we have seen that Indian rupee has depreciated to 74.5. This is the worst it has ever been. From that low, the rupee appreciated 5%. Okay. From almost here, 74.5, it has appreciated to 70.67. The reasons are that the crude price has reduced. This has come down to $62.85 per barrel. Okay, this is Brent, which is based on crude oil procured from North Sea, which is next to Norway. Okay, secondly, many foreign funds have come to India in form of FDI and FII. This has increased the inflow of dollar and this has reduced the outflow of dollar. Both of these things help to appreciate rupee. This will help India in two ways. First, it will help us in maintaining the tolerance limit for current account deficit, and the people who are suffering from high petrol and diesel prices will get respite from this measure. Okay. Drought. When and how does a state government declare one? This article is going to describe the procedure or the guidelines for declaring a drought. Okay. This is in the news because large areas of Maharashtra are dealing under drought now. This is not even summer, but there is already drought in this region. So it is going to be worse in the summer. Okay. Now, what are these guidelines? These guidelines are given by a manual published by Ministry of Agriculture in the year 2016. It has three steps. In the first step, the district officials will measure two mandatory indicators, that is rainfall deprivation. For example, if an average rainfall in a region is 100 centimeters, however, in that particular year it has received only 70 centimeters, so this is known as rainfall deviation. Secondly, dry spell. So, for example, a state has to get rainfall in November from northeast monsoon, however that has not happened and dry spell is continuing for 4-5 months. So these are the first two mandatory indicators. If these two indicators say that there is enough importance to consider drought, the second step is undertaken. In the second step, through remote sensing, the agriculture output, the vegetation, that is the forests, plants and etc., the soil moisture in the farms and the hydrology is taken into the consideration. If any of the three indicators are shown in the severe category, that is they are severely impacted by this, then it is declared as a severe drought. If two of the three chosen indicators are severe, then it is chosen as moderate or severe class. There is a choice. Okay. In the third step, what happens is that officials will go to the village and they will collect ground truth. This will help in making the final determination of the drought. So this is the procedure how a drought is declared in India. This is very important for civil service mains. Direct question can come on this. Okay, once the drought is determined to this procedure, the government issues a notification. This notification is valid for 6 months unless denotified earlier. Okay. This can also be a prelims question. What is the maximum limit on which the state government notification on drought is valid? Okay, it is 6 months. What is human biome? We know that human body contains lot of bacteria. It is not ourselves, but many of the bacteria lives in our gut, which is stomach, intestines, in our nasal cavity, etc. These bacteria are not harmful, but they are actually helpful to us. They help us in digesting complex carbohydrates and fats. They produce essential vitamins for us. They maintain immune system. That is, whenever a new virus or harmful pathogen comes into our body, this bacteria actually fights for us. This will help in maintaining the immune system. Therefore, it is seen as a first line of defense against pathogens. The recent research has shown that we people are very different based on our residence, our eating habits, our ethnicity, etc. The microbial communities in our stomach vary. Okay, this microbial diversity will help us in maintaining the health system. For example, whenever a person goes under very complex surgery or medical procedure, the antibiotics kill all the bacteria in the stomach, good bacteria. Therefore, that person's health will be disturbed. Recent research is showing that before such complex operation is done, doctors are now collecting these gut bacteria, and after the operation is done, they are reintroducing this bacteria. That is how important these bacteria are. Therefore, complex research or further research on this human biome is necessary. That is what is being done. Department of Biotechnology is funding this initiative under which human biome of Indians is being collected. Why is this important? What is the potential of India under this on human biome? Firstly, gut microbiota of Indians is very different from gut microbiota of other world. We already know that Indians are more immune to many allergies or many other diseases which are not, okay, compared to United people of US or Europe. They are very susceptible to many diseases. Okay, Indians are more immune. So this is because of gut microbiota. This is alleged by the scientists. So they want to study it. Secondly, India's large tribal population who are unaffected by modern diet, that is, they are not eating Western food or junk food, etc. So since thousands of years, their microbiota is the same. So scientists want to study the evolution of mutualism, that is, how we and microbes are helping each other. Okay, scientist wants to study. So this is the importance of human biome, and a research summit happened on this, and Department of Biotechnology is funding this. This is very important for health, which is in part of paper 2 general studies. Thank you. See you tomorrow.